Hi folks, it's Evil here from Thundermist Lure Company, and welcome to today's episode of Thundermist Fishing Tips. I'm out here with the Boatless angler himself. I've got Antonio with me today, and we've also got Dirk along with us today. Dirk's made the trip, eh? And well, it's been an eventful start to our day. We've got about an hour before the sun goes down. We made what, three stops, guys?
Three full stops.
Three stops for worms, and each place we stopped at was sold out, and the last place said they just sold the last dozen worms. So I went to plan B. The same place I was at, I picked up some corn, and they even opened it up for me. So what we're gonna do today, we're fishing an old quarry, and I've got the two T-turn rigged up here. And we're just gonna use corn. So originally we wanted to use worms. Actually, one of our subscribers said, can you fish with worms and just fish for whatever bites? And that's what we're doing today, except we're using corn. We have never fished here before. It's an old quarry. It's a revitalization site here in St. Catharines, right near Brock University. And all we're going to do today, this simple rig set up like this, and we're just going to cast it out. And a lot of people, there's a lot of quarries around in North America. They're readily available, and usually what you find in these quarries, oh, there's a bite right there. Look at that. Look at the bites there. Unbelievable.
That was quick.
There we go. there's a lot of quarries here in North America, and a lot of people fish quarries. They're readily available, and they're a lot of fun. And you know what? Usually what you find, you can find some largemouth bass in quarries, and typically catfish, and that's what we got here today. We got ourselves a nice bullhead right there. So we've loaded up with some corn, and we're gonna see what we can catch. And I know there are we read on the way in here that there are also largemouth bass in here. That's not a big bullhead, but that's a nice little bullhead catfish. Nonetheless, we have no nets with us. We like I say, just an impromptu. We had ourselves a nice dinner tonight. And now we're loading up with some corn and gonna do a little fishing here for about an hour before the sun goes down. And you know what, if there are catfish here, and there are, we might just continue fishing right into evening, because the catfish will bite also at nighttime as well. So the hooks as well, I'm just using a long-shank thin wire hook. It would be a size 6 hook that I'm using today. And it's quite a big area here actually, this particular area. And we can see some fish jumping, and I think I got real lucky with that one bite right away, but it'll be nice to hook into a bass, eh guys? We can get a largemouth?
It'll be pretty good. We don't have the bait really, but...
It's not really largemouth bait, but we have caught muskie on corn before.
Yeah.
You know, not fishing for muskie, but they will catch the corn. And one thing I think I will do is I'll just move my bait every so often if I don't get a bite, because this water is really murky, eh? It's a clay bottom here, so the water is very murky. So I'm gonna hold my line there, and then, oh, there's a bite. There was a bite right there. He just thought, there's another bite.
There's
You're on, Antonio?
Yeah. Bullhead.
Bullhead? Oh, you lost him. There's a catch and release. Mine has stopped biting unless he took my, oh, no, there he is. Oh,
that looks like a better bite.
I'm using a little ultralight. I've got a 4.5 foot. Ultralight rod. I'm running 4-pound test line, and that hook set was a major league hook set on a little rod. Wow, he's fighting. It's another bullhead. Oh, look at that. See the bites I had earlier? That's the advantages of using two hooks. My one hook here on the top is stripped, probably the same fish, and this one here has been hooked. And with the long shanked hooks, you've heard me mention this before, I like it because it gives you an area to grip that you can hold, and then usually get the hook out a little bit easier than if it was a short shanked hook. This one's in there really good in the side of the mouth. I'm going to poke my finger in there and just poke it out just like that. Another small catfish. Did you see yours, Antonio?
Yeah, it's the same size as that.
Same size, yeah?
Yeah.
So I've got two hooks here. I'm going to load up again. Dirk, they took your bait. It'd be nice to hook into a largemouth.
Be good. You try near the reeds maybe a little bit later.
Well, yeah, there's nice reeds here. Maybe I'll make a cast there next.
I just had a bite.
Did you get a bite?
Yeah.
That's the rod. Did you make that rod, Antonio?
I did, yeah.
Antonio does like to make his own fishing rods every so often. You've made yourself a heavy rod and an ultralight.
Yep.
And that's your ultralight.
Yep.
Small cork handle.
Oh, I just missed.
It's a September day. It's you don't have to stop fishing once September rolls around. It's mid-September, and it's quite nice out. And obviously the fish are still biting. There's no need to stop fishing once September comes around. In fact, there's a lot of great fishing to be had in the fall. And I highly recommend fishing as long as you possibly can right into the winter.
I think I lost a piece of corn, but I put three pieces on there, so. Oh, there's a bite, Antonio.
Really?
Yeah. Small bite. Oh, that was a good bite. That was a good bite. There we go.
Did you get him?
Yeah, I got him. Oh, it's small. Let's see what we got here. It's tiny. Look at this.
A rock bass.
It's a rock bass, yeah. A little rock bass. Look at that. My corn's all gone there, too.
Tiny biting, too.
You got a small bite as well. There you go.
I got him.
Catfish?
Tiny catfish. Wow.
A little bit bigger than the bass I just got. Okay, I'm going to put three pieces of corn on each hook. Okay. Where are you? Just right here?
Yeah, just straight out.
Talk about comfortable fishing. This is the boatless angler, eh? Comfort. The comfort of the boatless angler.
Pretty clean fishing.
It is. Dirks went down there to fish down there on the other side. It is clean fishing. I'm just going to move my bait a bit because if there's nothing there, oh, there's a bite. See that?
I got one too.
Yeah, I got a bite now.
I got a rock bass.
You got a rock bass as well? Yeah, sometimes you got to move your bait to where the fish are. And I had a bite and then he stopped. Unless he took my bait. Oh, no, there you go. Got him. I think there's small bass over there, Antonio. That's what the... Oh, wow. Okay, another rock bass. I think we got a fish out there maybe a little bit. It's funny, a fish out here, caught bullhead, cast over there and got rock bass. So let's see what happens if I cast in between. I'm going to cast out a little bit further too, just to see what's out there. Okay, I'm down there now.
What'd you say, it's about 6-7 feet deep?
I would say it's about 6 feet out there by the time the sinker hit the bottom. And you know what, folks, quarries are a great place to come if you're if you have youngsters or you just want to get out a bit and have a day, get a line wet for an hour or so and have some fun. They're readily available. They're all over North America, and you can catch some fish and have some fun. Now, we're not getting anything big here tonight, but our first time here, and we're having a little bit of fun. Yeah. There's a bite. There we go. You're on?
Yeah.
That's a nice... Oh, there's a good bite. Oh. That's pretty small. Small rock bass. I think that's what I had biting on mine. Maybe we should change spots. Oh, there was a big jump over there. Oh, they're still biting. He's still biting.
I got one.
Oh, this is...
They're all the same size.
I think that's what's biting on mine, is bite, bite, stop. Oh, that was something bigger that jumped there.
Should have brought some topwater bait.
You know what? That would not have been a bad idea. Wow. Well, you know what? That's a good sign, though, these tiny little fish in this quarry, that these rock bass are reproducing.
Yeah. Could be some big ones, too.
Exactly.
Right?
So I mean about moving the line, just have it sit. I like to have it sit. And in this darker, murky water, if nothing... Oh, there's a... Oh, that was a good bite. Oh, yeah.
That looks good.
Yeah. But see what I did? I moved my bait about a foot or two. So what we're doing, I'm finding the fish instead of the fish finding the bait.
Fish?
I might be, I don't know. It's definitely not a little rock bass, that's for sure. And here he is, it's a catfish.
There we go, another bullhead. They're not big, but look at the belly on them. So these fish are, they're thriving here by the looks of it. They're eating and thriving, and that's a great sign for a quarry. That's a healthy a healthy little bullhead right there. Well, we've been out here for
10 minutes, maybe.
10 minutes. You know, fishing quarries is a lot of fun. Get yourself some ultralight gear. Like I said, a setup like this, with this happens to be a 2-T-turn rig. You could run 1 T-turn just off to a hook line and sinker method. Very, very simple system. If you're going to use worms, what I would be using today, what we wanted to use was just a little piece of night crawler. That's all we would have used today, but they didn't have any, so we opted for corn instead. But the corn is working, and we're catching some fish, and we're having some fun, and you know what? At the end of the day, that's what it's all about. And if you've got some youngsters, take them out to some local quarry and get a little ultralight gear. They'll have a riot, and you know what? So will you. I want to thank you so much for tuning in to today's episode of Thundermist Fishing Tips. And as always, folks, until next time, good luck and good fishing.
Very nice.
We could have went with light action if we wanted. No landing net today. Okay, red horse sucker. You can see the red on the fins there.